Now we'll start our learnings with this topic, punctuation. So punctuation marks such as full stop, comma, quotation marks, capital letters, these are used in the written language. And why punctuation marks are used? So that we can read and understand a written passage, a written paragraph or a written text clearly. Now what all are included in punctuation marks? Full stop, comma, semicolon, colon, interrogation mark, exclamation mark, single inverted comma, double inverted comma and capital letters. First of all, we learn capitalization. This thing you know, that a sentence always begins with a capital letter, and proper nouns such as a name of a specific person, a name of a specific place also begin with capital letters. Now we learn full stop. The full stop represents the longest pause. Where we use full stop? At the end of an assertive or imperative sentence. Assertive or imperative sentence means a sentence which states something. For example, Amit is a skilled mechanic. Full stop. Now, after abbreviations and initials also, we use full stop. For example, M, full stop, A, full stop. As dot, P dot, Sharma. Now, these are the initials of someone's name, so that's why we have put full stop. Now, but when the abbreviation ends with the final letter of the full word, we prefer to omit the full stops. See here, Mr. This, the short form for this is MR, the starting letter and the final letter. So in this case, we do not use full stop. See here also, for doctor, the short form is DR. The starting letter is D and the final letter is R. So here also we will not use the full stop. We omit the full stop in such case. Now we will see the usage of comma. The comma indicates the shortest pause. Where it is used to separate three or more words of the same part of speech. Nouns, verbs, adjectives, adverbs. Now, whenever we want to separate words which are having the same part of speech, so we can use comma to separate them. See here, for example, I want to buy some cakes, pastries, sandwiches and some biscuits. Now as you can see that cakes, pastries, sandwiches and some biscuits, these are what? These are nouns, and these are more than this is more than one word. Cakes, pastries, sandwiches and some biscuits. So in order to separate them, we'll use comma. Now second, Aziz bathed, ate, dressed and went out. Now you can see that these are verbs, and in order to separate them we used comma. Now he is efficient, hardworking and sincere. These are adjectives. These are describing the quality of a person. So again, in order to separate them we used comma. Now he lifted the precious statue gently, reverently and carefully. These are adverbs, and in order to separate them again we used comma. Now to mark off phrases in apposition. When two words or phrases refers to the same person or same thing and we have not used any connecting word in order to connect them, then these are known as in apposition. These are said to be in apposition. See here, for example, Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation, preached non-violence. Now in the above sentence, as you can see that Mahatma Gandhi and the father of the nation, these both phrases, this name and this phrase refers to the same person, that is Mahatma Gandhi. So the father of the nation is in opposition to Mahatma Gandhi because I have not used any connecting word. Here I have not said that Mahatma Gandhi, who is the father of the nation, preached non-violence. I have not used any connecting word in order to connect these two. So that's why I have put comma here, and the father of the nation is in opposition to Mahatma Gandhi. Now, in order to separate words, phrases or clauses in a sentence, we use comma. For example, the police did not, comma, however, comma, succeed in punishing him. And to avoid the repetition of a verb, for example, Richa is an engineer and Rishi a technician. Here I could have said that Rishi is a technician, but to avoid the repetition of a verb, what I said, Richa is an engineer and Rishi, comma, a technician. Now, to separate the subordinate clause of any kind that comes before the principal clause. Now here, as you can see, that if it rains is a subordinate clause, it is dependent on the next clause, and this the match will have to be cancelled. This is the principal clause or independent clause. So in order to separate these both clauses, we can use comma. Now we learn semicolon. The semicolon indicates a longer pause than the comma. It is usually followed by conjunctions like and, but, or. It is used to separate the clauses of a compound sentence when they contain a comma. Now, what is a compound sentence? A compound sentence is a sentence that has at least two independent clauses. See here, for example, the sweet melodious music came to a close and there was thunderous applause. Now, as you can see that the sweet melodious music came to a close. This is an independent clause. This is complete in its meaning. And there was thunderous applause. This is also an independent clause. So, and these both independent clauses are connected by a word which is and this and is a conjunction. So these both independent clauses are connected by a conjunction. So this whole is sentence is a compound sentence. Now in order to separate the clauses that are there in the compound sentence, we can use semicolon. See, the sweet melodious music came to a close, semicolon. This whole independent clause is separated from this independent clause. There was thunderous and there was thunderous applause. Now second one, our teacher was a simple, modest, unassuming person. Now again, this is a independent, this is an independent clause. This is complete in its meaning. Semicolon, but is a conjunction here. We all respected him. We all respected him is also an independent clause. It is complete in its meaning. So this whole sentence is a compound sentence. And in order to separate the clauses in the compound sentence, we can use semicolon. Now when sentences are closely connected in thought, then we can separate them using a semicolon. See here, for example, reading makes a full man, conference a ready man, writing an exact man. So here, as you can see, that reading, conferencing, writing, these all are closely connected in thought. So in order to separate these sentences, we can use semicolon. Now we learn colon. The colon indicates a much longer pause than the semicolon. Now we'll see its usage. To introduce a quotation, for example, our teacher says, colon, hard work is the key to success. Now what our teacher says, that hard work is the key to success. This is a quotation which is said by our teacher. So in order to introduce this quotation, first of all we have used colon and then we have introduced the quotation that our teacher has said to us. Now to introduce a list, for example, these are the things we need to take with us. Colon, a torch, a flask of coffee, some biscuits, sandwiches and sweets. Now as you can see that these are the list of things that we need to take with us, that we need to carry with us. So in order to introduce this list of things, what we have done, first of all we have put colon and then we have introduced all the things that we are about to take with us. Now to introduce an explanation, a statement or a proposition, for example, the excuse he gave was this. Colon, he had not properly understood the rules of the game. Now whenever we want to introduce any explanation, a statement, then also we can use colon. What excuse he gave? The excuse he gave was this, colon. Then we have explained the excuse that he gave. The excuse that he gave was he had not properly understood the rules of the game. Now interrogation mark. The interrogation mark is used after a question. For example, have you completed your assignment? Question mark. This we all know that interrogation mark is always used when we are asking a question to someone. Here I am asking a question that have you completed your assignment, and then I have put interrogation mark because here I am asking a question to someone that whether he has completed his assignment or not. Now exclamation mark. When we use exclamation mark, whenever we are shocked or surprised or there is a sudden utterance, then we use exclamation mark. See, for example, oh dear, then exclamation mark. Alas, exclamation mark. Then hello, exclamation mark. What a terrific idea, exclamation mark. Now inverted commas. Inverted commas or quotation marks are used to suggest direct speech. That means the speech or the statement that is directly given by the speaker. So to enclose those actual words, to enclose the actual quotation of a speaker, we use inverted commas. Now you can either use single or double inverted commas. For example, I'll see what I can do about it, she said. Now what she said, what are the words which are said by her, that I'll see what I can do about it.